Taxpayers around the world are giving fossil fuel producers $5 trillion in free money every year. That's as much as the Iraq and Afghanistan wars put together. This is based on a new study by the International Monetary Fund that estimated the amount of the subsidies to fossil fuel companies. And $5 trillion is a lot of money. The reason they think it's so much is because fossil fuel producers don't pay to clean up the air or the water. They don't have to deal with the medical costs of air pollutants. And the researchers bunch all of this into subsidies, effectively making the taxpayers foot the bill to clean up and pay just to keep using fossil fuels. For example, if a company wants to drill a well that may not hit oil, the cost is 100% tax deductible. It's a direct taxpayer subsidy. But the paper also included the more intangible costs of climate change effects, the cost to supply oil versus what consumers pay, and even deaths from air pollution. Again, this added up to $5 trillion. There is a pile of research saying carbon and particulate-emitting fossil fuels cost more than you think. For example, gas in the United States is currently $2.40 a gallon. A 2015 study says that the true cost, when we add in the cost of air pollution from burning it, is $6.20 a gallon. Diesel would be even more. And coal power would add a quarter for every kilowatt hour. Calculating these hidden subsidies is not new. It's been studied controversially many times. But it's important to bring it up because it doesn't have to be this way. 139 countries could be 100% powered by wind, water, and solar by 2050, says another new study. The study lead says every country that we examined has sufficient resources to power itself. Just imagine, 139 countries with 100% clean renewables, no carbon emissions, including the US and China. That's incredible. Not to mention, we wouldn't have to pay pollution subsidies. So I have to ask, why do we pay all this money to keep using non-renewable coal and oil? Do you think we should fund renewables or stick to what we know with fossil fuels? Let us know your thoughts down in the comments. And if you want to know which of these fuel sources are the most efficient, watch this video here. It might surprise you. Take a second and subscribe. And if you want to talk about this anymore, come find me on Twitter @TraceDominguez.